Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how we can use OpenAI's image generation API with JavaScript Node.js code. So let's get started. So for this, the prerequisite is going to be you must have Node.js installed on your system. So currently I'm in my Visual Studio Code and I've just opened a new folder. So just go here and create a .js file. So let me just name it as new.js, something like this. So we'll be requiring the OpenAI npm package. Just click on terminal, new terminal, and make sure that you are inside this particular folder over here. It's going to be npm I OpenAI. Just hit enter. So you'll be getting the node modules and package.json file. So here you'll be having OpenAI, and this is the latest version. So this is good. So let's just begin the coding. First, we'll be importing the OpenAI package. So it's going to be OpenAI. So this is just a variable. You can name this anything you want, and it's going to be require within double quotes OpenAI. All right, and next is going to be the OpenAI API key. So it's going to be const OpenAI equal to new OpenAI, which is the above variable, and inside circular bracket and a curly bracket we need to have the key API key. So make sure that you have the capital K over here, otherwise you will be getting an error. And inside this, within double quotes, here we need to specify our OpenAI API key. So for that, just Google OpenAI. I hope you will be having a ChatGPT or OpenAI account already created. So if not, you can just create your account there. Just select this, click on login. I've already logged in with my account, so click API. And to the left, you'll be having something called as API keys over here. Click that, and this is a spot where you will be creating your OpenAI API key. Just click on create new secret key and just copy it. Done. Don't share this key to anyone, and just paste your key inside this. You can just have it in an environment variable or whatever the way you want. For demo purpose, I'm just directly hard coding it over here. So this is now fine. And next thing is going to be the function. So I'm not gonna like use any calls or post or fetch operation, something like that. I'm just going to directly use a function, so you can just modify the code based upon that. So the function, let me just name it as const image generate, something like this. And this is going to be an async function, so async await, just a normal arrow function. So we'll be getting a response now. So this response is what the thing that OpenAI's image generation API gives us. It basically gives us image URLs, and we can use these URLs to display them in UI or store in our database. So that's a response that we will be getting. So let's just have const response equal to await space OpenAI. So this variable that we have over here, and this variable should come here, dot images dot generate. So you need to have this again, circular bracket, curly bracket, and here we'll be passing some parameters. First is going to be the model, and the currently the latest model is going to be Dall-E 3. If you like Dall-E 2, you can use Dall-E 2, or else you can just go with the latest model. And next one is going to be the prompt that we will be giving. So I'll just give a lion as a prompt. So you can even get this as a input from the user in case if you're having a UI or something. And next is going to be the number of images that is going to be generated. So n, I'll just give it as 1. So if you give n as 2, we will be getting 2 URLs as a response. And final thing is going to be the dimension of the image, the height and width. So within double quotes, I will just specify this 1024 times 1024, and here like, and it's not equal to, it's colon over here. So now we are good. So what we can do is, let's just now console the response. Alright, let's just have a console log, console.log response. I'll just print this variable, and I'm just going to call this function inside my file itself, because I'm not having here any post or fetch calls. I'm just, you know, directly hard coding the function over here. So I'm just calling this function now. So this will like hit the OpenAI API, we'll be getting the response, and we're just consoling that log the response, and here's the starting point of this code. All right, saving it. So for running this, it's going to be node space your file name dot js, and just hit enter. So this is the response that we get from OpenAI. I'm just directly printing it. So we have some keys and its value. So it's a JSON basically. And inside that we are having a key called as created, and we are having data. And the great thing about OpenAI's image generation is that I just gave a normal prompt of two words, a lion, that's it. But OpenAI has regenerated our prompt like this. So here you can see it's super cool. It has created its own surroundings, the description of the lion, and so many background things. And it has also given us the URL over here. So if you want to view the image, what you can do is you can just press Control and it will just click it and just click on open. So this will open us the image in the default browser. So this is the image that we are getting. This is like hyper realistic, that good it is. And next thing is, what if I gave here two images? So if I just go here and type n equal to 2, and I don't know why, but Dall-E 3 currently gives error if we ask for two images. So here you can see it says error, you must provide n equal to 1 for this model. So in case if you want like two or more images, what you can do is you can just change the model to Dall-E 2. Alright, so now if I rerun this code, I'll be getting two URLs under the data thing. Alright, so here you can see this is the first image that I get, and this Dall-E 2, and this is the second image that I get. So this is how you access in case if you want multiple images. So final thing what I want to show you is how you can just extract this URLs alone as a list, because in case if you are sending it as a data, I'm pretty sure that you won't be sending the whole thing. You just want the filtered URLs alone for UI purposes, so you can render them as a image in the UI. So for that, what we can do is, let's just have the response. So let me have it const image URL equal to response dot, first we need to get access to this data key, response dot data. So by using this, this image URL will have this list. Basically the image URL will contain this list, and the elements are going to be this JSON, and inside that JSON we are having a key URL and its value, the image URL. So now we need to just map this thing to just filter out the URLs. So for doing that, let's just have another variable const image URL list equal to image URL dot map, so that have image, and so this will basically iterate through each and every element. So image, and inside that we are having this URL thing, so it's going to be image dot URL, that's it. So this basically corresponds to this direct value, this direct value, and this will just push these both values inside a list named as image URL list. So I'll just copy this now, and let me just now console.log, that's it. I'm just directly consoling this thing. I'm not even consoling the response now. I'm only consoling the final filtered URL image list, saving it. And here you can see I'm getting the URLs over here. And for your information, the entire code that I have typed over here is available in my website. The link is in the description. If you want to just copy paste it, you can just head over to my website, available in the description. So here you can see I'm just having a list. We're having two elements. One is the URL, another one is URL. And you can just send this to directly to the UI. You can just send it as a response. So just a small filtration process over here. All right. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in AI and OpenAI API, as well as other programming videos and cloud operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.